Here, eat some of this. Here.
Hi there, come on in.
Buenos dias.
So, what do you need? Mighty fine, if I do say so. Ah, very presidential. The mutton chops. Mutton chops make the face strong and square. Please, tell your friends about it.
All right, you know where I am.
The word is excuse me.
Morning, friend.
Hello. Good to have you. Let me know when something catches your eye. I have to say, that looks just fantastic on you. If you have any questions, you just let me know. Let me know what I can do to help you leave here feeling good and looking great. Now that goes with just about any outfit. You'll be getting a little more attention from the fairer sex wearing that. I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. Come now, don't doubt yourself. That looks excellent on you. Oh, my man, if I had a dollar for every time somebody said to me, "Haven't I met you somewhere else?" A properly worn vest always commands respect. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence. So, what do you think? Wearing it out? It's the little touches that make an outfit stand out. Are you looking for something to go with what you just bought?
Goodbye. Someone there? Hello? Please, can you spare some money for a blind man?
Here you go,
oh,
friend.
Bless you, mister. Truly, you're a saint. Yes, sir. There should be more people in the world like you. God bless.
Let's go, girl.
Please, anything you can spare would be much appreciated.
Shit! Tarnation!
Fine morning, partner.
Ah, it's you. Travelers have brought you back my way, have they? Remember, read the label. Ah, you supplies to sell. Okay, I'll take a look.
Let me just stock up on my supplies. Thank you, Doc. Thanks, partner. Easy there.
Hey, come on, what? Touch it.
Do you need something
from
me?
What are you trying to do?
Mind yourself.
Cuidado.
Hey.
Buenas.
moving.
Good to see you again. So, what do you have?
Where are you going?
Okay, let's take a look at it.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Fine vegetables here.
Nothing quite like wearing your best day's work.
Well,
so very interesting.
Wish I never had to take my stall into the city. Just like I wish country folk had any damn money. I've run this stall all the way from here to the border.
The northern border. And I've never come.
Yep.
Dumb galoot.
Hello again, mister.
Come on, folks. Get your meat here.
Lot more in there than what you see on the shelves. I ensure all my dry groceries are fresh and well packed. You got it.
That's it for now.
Thank you.
You all right, girl?
Yes.
¿Cómo estás?
Hello, sir.
Oh, really?
Be with you in just a moment. Be a lot easier for you once you're all square. Ah, hello. What do you need?
Thank you for your help.
Hey, look out!
I gunch. Stay holstered around here, friend.
Ah, get out the way, you damn fool.
Mister.
What did I do to you?
Oh. Oh.
Oh.
What the hell?
You ain't got no love.
Oh. Oh, God. Is this piss?
I've been covered in worse, friend.
Just had to be me.
Pick 'em up, cowboy.
Paid us for one. Us laborers been duped.
Yeah, real funny, Dutch.
Oh, I thought so. So, here we are in a strange land of papists and rapists. America's very own Gomorrah.
Yeah, cities all look the same to me. So, how you get on?
I've been asking around about Mr. Bronte. And from what I've heard, this establishment is our best lead, but I haven't had any joy in there so far.
So, I should just give it a shot?
I think so. Just keep it cool.
You know me? I'll meet you back here anon.
Funny you should say that.
Well, you know how it is.
Can I get a drink here?
That's the state of Le Mans for you. America's dirty little French secret.
Over here.
That's why we love it.
Born and raised. I'm sorry. Please excuse me. I seem to have some very impatient customers. Now, how can I help? You look like a whiskey man.
Sure.
Dollar, please.
For a whiskey?
Oh, that's the real stuff. From Scotland.
Okay. Here, have one for yourself.
Well, thank you.
So, mister, can I ask you a question? You ever hear of a fella by the name of Bronte?
Who's asking?
Me. I'm asking.
No, leave it, friend.
What do you mean, leave it?
Look, I don't know what business you in, but leave it, friend. You and your pal that was in here before.
Bronte?
Angelo Bronte? Mr. Big? Mr. Italian spaghetti-eating long streak of piss big? Yeah, he makes my skin crawl. I'm so squally, a cocksucker. You know what I mean, friend?
Where can I find him?
Oh, well, I reckon you can talk to them kids in the alley. They'll know, I guess. Oh, and friend, you be careful now. Immigrants, they're not to be trusted.
Arre, caballo!
Good morning.
and turn it three times?
Yes. And then after 24 men, find any married person, male or female, wearing a wedding ring, turn that ring twice, and then...
Hi there. Have you seen any kids around here?
Oh, yeah. Just through that archway there.
Hey. Hey, you got a cigarette, mister?
Maybe.
Huh?
I'm looking for a fellow named Angelo Bronte. Italian.
I know him. Everyone knows him.
Where is he?
We'll take you to him. What it'll cost?
I reckon I can pay.
$5.
Where does he live? New York?
I'm an entrepreneur. You don't want to pay, then I don't want to walk.
Oh, man. That's a bad breath. Here. Come on.
This away. Let's go, mister. You coming, Cleet? Stay close. Easy to get lost around here. Come on, then. You new to the city, mister?
Pretty much.
Don't worry. No one knows it as good as me and Cleet.
Is that right?
Hope you won't need his services, but you got the doctor on the corner there. Nice enough, fella. That's Baird and Schreiber on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister. Modeled on the famous church in Toulouse, which is in France. You been to Toulouse, mister?
No.
We're Catholics here, mister. Ain't Baptist or nothing.
My mama said they used to burn Protestants and all, but,
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, you little pair of shits!
Get going! He's coming after us!
Stop, you shit!
Shit went that way.
Thanks for that. Friend.
Bonjour.
No. Oh, God!
Come on! Keep up!
Hey! Moron!
Hey, kid, watch where you're going!
Hey, come on, watch.
Bye, mister!
I'm telling you, a cucumber's definitely a fruit.
Since when?
Since forever. I read in the newspaper.
Oh, so it must be true. So they tell you your dog's a cat now. You just start calling him...
Feather,
fur, you name it, I got it. Hey, what
What's the problem, Fred?
Give me my things, boy.
What are you talking about, friend?
I ain't your friend, but that kid is, and he robbed from me. Now, give me back my stuff and take me to Angelo Bronte.
Senor Bronte.
That kid was gonna show me before he robbed me. Now, come on.
You new in town, mister?
Come on.
Mr. Bronte's got a lot of friends, mister, but I ain't never seen you.
We ain't friends.
You don't like no one, mister. Mr. Bronte, he's got fine hair. He got a beautiful house, and I am proud to work for him. He got 50 men, mister. Why he gonna care a thing about you?
I just want to speak with him.
I'm sure you do, mister. You and them friends of yours been asking about him all over town. He been mighty disrespected. Bunch of muddy Yankees in town asking questions. Well, you and your friend should pay him a visit, mister. He's got a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Hey, yokel.
Now, get out of here.
Please.
Go get yourself something to eat.
Sir, I want you to have this.
Thanks, friend.
It's nice to give something instead of just begging. I hate asking for money like a goddamn worm. Groveling here in the dirt.
Fine morning. Burner.
Yeehaw! Whoa.
Look out!
Watch yourself, partner.
Buenos días, señor.
So you getting along okay?
On the best.
I've seen vagrants making their beds in the streets at night.
Where you been?
Getting robbed?
Who by?
Bunch of children.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him. Apparently lives in a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Good work.
So what now?
We go pay him a visit. I'll get John. You meet us there. Whatever it takes, we need to get that boy back.
I cannot decide which I like less. The swamps or the city. Both are full of parasites, reptiles, and slime. We're a long way east to land we know, and far from real open country.
So...
Long time, girl.
Hi there.
I've been going after folks' pockets. You ain't scaring nobody.
Easy now.
Hey, be careful.
Buy me a drink, mon ami.
Damn, I miss my... horse.
Sure, what you want?
Brandy!
Two brandies, bud.
It's $2 a glass.
Oh, better be good then.
It's the best.
Thank you. Santé. It's quite a country you're building here, eh?
Well, me personally?
I don't know. What do you do?
Mostly, I just shoot people.
How very American of you. I love it.
What do you do?
Oh, mostly I pose, I show off, I complain.
Oh, how very French.
I know. I am ridiculous. I have been all over the world. I have seen the sights, and I have discovered the one eternal truth that I am a pies, how do you say, all ass.
Asshole?
That too.
Well, at least you have some self-knowledge. Where were you on your journey?
All the civilized world. Painting my little pictures, meeting the locals, you know.
You a painter?
No, I'm a whole ass. I thought we had covered this.
Yeah, but you paint.
Not according to salons at Paris. No, according to them, I cannot draw, I cannot paint, and I should go away. And so I went away.
You miss Paris?
That smelly, filthy place with old buildings and ghosts and shit and French people. I have that right here.
I guess so.
You know,
Arthur.
Charles. You know, Arthur, don't believe in art. It's lies. Believe in women. They're the truth. Art is lies, but the vagina, that is truth. Breasts is truth. Art. For it is.
If you say so. Oh,
trust me, I've tried both. One is better. Much better. So, I must be boring you, but here.
What is it?
It's just a little doodle. You know, entirely worthless unless you want to wipe your bottom with it. But I wanted to say thank you for the drinks.
Well, that's very kind, Charles.
No matter.
Good meeting you.
If no one else will buy me a drink, I will go. Idiot. All of
them. Finish the bottle, are we? What can I get you?
Whiskey, please.
So you find Mr. Bronte?
No, whiskey. I thought better of it.
Wise move. You don't want to get tangled up with that feller.
So I've heard.
Where you from, mister?
Keep it coming for you?
Me? I'm St. Denis, born and bred. This is the real city right here. Might not look like much, but St. Francis is the soul. Not the mansion district with all those big old houses. You won't hear music like you do around here nowhere else in the world, right?
Morning.
He puts rhythm in the white man.
Bye.
Okay, my girl. Yeah, there's a girl.
You, kind sir. Will you help the poor?
I ain't so kind.
Yes, you are, sir. You have it in you, I can tell.
I'm a nasty bit of work, father.
You're wrong on two counts, sir. I'm a humble brother, a penitent monk, not a priest, and you're a magnificent bit of work. You may have made some poor choices, but which of us hasn't?
You have no idea.
But you do. And God does, and that's enough for me and for him.
We shall see.
That we shall, sir. But why don't you hedge your bets and give two bits to the poor? There are so many who will go hungry tonight.
Sure.
Bless you, sir.
How you getting on, anyhow?
These are a somewhat apathetic lot, I'm afraid.
My mentor says that America is designed to induce apathy in people.
It's a wonderful insight. He must be a wise man, your mentor.
Well, sometimes he's a downright fool, but, well, usually he's the best man I know.
That's wonderful. The thing is, well, poverty will always be with us. But slavery, I thought we had banished that. Like Saint-Denis is acting as a staging post for shipping slaves out to some of the islands.
I don't believe you. It's 1899.
Maybe you should take a look for yourself. I've heard that the pawnbroker down the block around the corner, the one with the green door, well, they say he sells more than forlorn trinkets. Help the poor.
Excuse your...
Hey, try going around people.
Hi there, mister. Feel free to browse.
Shall do.
Got a few paintings over there. Something for the wife, maybe?
Something don't seem right.
Sir, what are you doing back there?
It was back here. Looks like this pulls out or something.
Pulls out?
How about you open that door?
Door? What door?
The hidden door. Or I'll open the hidden door in your chest.
They made me do it. I was always good to them, but They forced me to do it, sir. I swear.
Open the door. Now!
Oh, okay, okay. Just pull the big red book on the bookshelf. It's called The Scourge of Crossbreeding by Harold McDougall.
Son of a bitch.
Cállate. Hello? ¿Hay alguien ahí? Por favor. Ayúdanos. Help, please. Help, please.
Don't worry. I'm on your side.
¿Quién eres?
Please, I'm on your side. It's gonna be okay.
Gracias, señor. Muchas gracias.
Come with me. Don't worry. You're gonna be all right now. I promise. That's it. Come on. You'll be safe soon. This way. Not much farther.
Poor bastards.
¿Quién es este hombre?
No lo sé. Estamos libres y eso es lo que importa. Tenemos que confiar en él.
Hello?
Welcome back. Brother.
Brother Dorkin's friend.
Arthur. Arthur Morgan. Come on. You were right. Found these two imprisoned in that shop.
Oh, my. That's... Well, they are blessed to have met you, Arthur.
Trust me in that. They're very unusual. I don't think they speak much English.
My brothers, come. Let's go get something to eat. Manger. Comida, please.
Hey, he forgot this.
Oh. Yes. Thank you. Here. Payment. For your services. I could not have freed these men myself.
Give it to the poor, brother.
Thank you. I will. Like I said, magnificent. Come on. Come. Come see me again sometime. I often work at the old church on Gaspar Street in St. Francis.
trouble.
Excellent.
What?
Listen, bit of a weird question, but do you know where I might find some moonshine?
What?
Moonshine. You know, strong liquor. Over strong.
Why, you want to get over drunk?
No, it's not for drinking.
What is it for?
Oh, I just need some.
Well, as luck would have it, you are in the legal hooch capital of America. Ooh. There's plenty of real booze here. Yeah. But for shine, well, I'm guessing you'd need to go out into the woods. Mm. I mean, I know you'd have to go out into the woods.
Now listen, I don't need that much.
How much?
About 100 gallons.
Of shine?
It. Yes, thereabouts.
Why?
Oh, all right, I'm trying. I'm building a machine. A machine of love.
100 gallons of hooch and love's gonna come pretty cheap.
Please, friend. I'll pay. Just bring it here. It's for a good cause.
Well, if anyone knows who's moving that kind of shine, it'll be that stagecoach guy in Rhodes. It's okay, girl. Just a scratch.
Crazy!
What's all this trouble about?
Try again. Please. Please.
It is
Coroner?
Sister, my friend, Mr. Morgan.
Oh, sir. Brother Dorkings told me about the wonderful thing you did.
Oh, he talks a lot of nonsense. No offense.
None taken. None taken at all. Hey! Stop!
These kids are the worst!
Don't hurt him, please!
We'll be at the cathedral.
You little bastards!
Oh!
You all right?
Oh, I'll live.
Kid did this?
You know him?
He robbed me. Which way you go?
That way, I think.
Thank you.
Get off me!
Where's my watch, you little weasel?
I don't know nothing about no damn watch.
Last Saturday...
Hey, you! Get your hands off of that boy right now.
You stole my watch.
Right now. Before I smash your head in that wall.
All right, all right. Forget it. Little shit ain't worth it.
Thanks, mister.
You got lucky this time, kid.
You want some company, mister?
No.
You sure?
Hey.
What?
I know you. This is Downs?
Oh, no. Not you. Get away.
How?
Now.
I mean, hey.
Help! Help!
Hold on!
This man is bothering
now.
Me! Someone help me! Officer, help!
Sorry about that.
What?
Thank you.
Every day. It's a new challenge, Father. Mr. Morgan!
Excuse me, Father. Sister, I got your cross.
You didn't!
Oh, I did.
Oh, I hope the boy...
He's fine, physically. Mentally, he's a piece of work, but who am I to say?
Brother Dorkins was right about you. You are the most wonderful man.
Brother Dorkins is greatly deceived, I'm afraid, but I'm happy to help a little.
Thank you. You see, it's a thing, but my mother gave it to me when I was a novice. Shortly before she passed, you are the most wonderful man.
Well, excuse me, Father. Sister, enjoy your day.
See, Father? Brother Dorkins found him. I told you. Brother Dorkins was fantastic.
Howdy. of the way.
See you back, sir.
Good on you. Get a fresh start. Hope your journey is a good one.
Leaving me, huh?
Sure.
Yeah, we'll leave this there.
Who's up to?
It's Mr. Black's fault.
His fault to Darky White. Although I don't know why they call him that. Look at him.
Don't you start now.
I'll knock the color clean off you. Come on.
And I'll tell you, you lily livered.
Enough. You two fools look like you've just run off a chain gang.
Yeah, what of it?
What are you doing?
Starving.
They got bounty posters for us all over town.
And we can't go into town to get supplies.
Say, mister, maybe you can do us fools a favor. We ain't bad guys at all. He's okay. Even for a darkie.
Shut it, you pasty-faced streak of piss!
Yeah, I had up to here with you.
Enough! Do your goddamn favor what you want.
Maybe you can go into town and take down them wanted posters of us.
Okay.
Maybe meet us back at the campfire in the woods and tell us how you did.
Maybe bring us a little box of meat.
Don't push your luck.
Nice fella.
Yeah, you love nice fellas.
Don't you start up again. Just shut up.
You shut up!
Hopping ever since.
Ain't no fun.
Oh, I know.
It ain't my fault.
Hello, mister.
Hey! Hey, it's good to see you again, friend. But, what you doing here?
Just visiting old friends, I guess.
Well, you better get out of here. There's a bunch of government agents I met asking about you all across town. Yeah, them and a bunch of bounty hunters, too, I think.
So?
Yeah. Yeah, but you don't seem too scared.
Guess not.
Well, they seem pretty mad. What'd you do?
Nothing good.
Well, you better get out of here.
How's things, huh?
Nothing, Carver. Business has been steady.
Good day to you.
Hey, I need to get to that poster behind you. Would you move a little?
I will not. Deputy put up plenty. Go get one of those.
Show me something I haven't.
Please, mister, I'll just reach by. It won't take but a second.
I'm leaning on it. Find one that ain't in use.
Hey, move! I need that poster.
Oh, I'll move, all right. How's this for moving? You ain't the law, you know.
Hit like a child.
This is what you want?
You've earned this.
No!
Come on.
Eight.
Next time, avoid me.
Worse than worse.
No, it was one for gossip. Jethro Mingle thought gossip. But as usual, you're spreading lies.
Lies?
Every fool knows the charges were trumped up.
But the darling killed a white man.
Jimmy Holdacre had a weak heart.
Has anyone seen an Englishman called Gavin?
Evening.
Have you seen Gavin?
You still haven't found him?
Nope. But I won't give up. He's lost. One morning, I just woke up and he wasn't there. Someone must have taken him.
Maybe he just left.
Gavin? No. No. We were best mates. I mean, really, best mates. He'd never leave me. Never.
Gavin!
I am so worried.
Gav!
Can you hold up a second?
Whoa, Gav!
Gav!
Where are you?
Where are you?
Mister, I need that poster. There's been a recall.
I want born yesterday. This one's mine, so you can go and get your own.
The hell you
doing?
Get
this off of me!
Hold still, mister.
Hey! Hey! The hell you doing? You dirty bastard!
You don't mind, do you?
So help me God, you give that back! Those boys was mine!
Out of the way! You'll be all right.
This is just...
Away our weapons and our whips, Cooper.
This is just too bad.
Gav! Gavin!
I mean, nobody's seen hide nor hair on it.
Out of your hands now, mister.
No! Help! Gah! This hurts. Let me go. What the hell?
I'll be damned.
Oh, you should see yourself. Don't reckon you're gonna remember much of this. So, that's something at least. Well, look at you.
Stay calm now.
Right here. Hey, what's your business here?
Come on, girl.
truth now!
You get your hands off her! You brought hell down on yourself.
I've taken a liking to killing you! Have this!
Okay, girl.
Idiot. Yep.
How do you do, sir?
That's the man there. Rotten.
That's so.
Well,
glad you dropped in. I've got that, information you asked for.
Need something more specific this time. A wagon full of moonshine.
Well, you might just be in luck.
I knew I picked the right fella to speak to.
We've had quite enough of your kind here.
About that gunfight out in the cornfield by Brayway Manor. Probably blame that on the Grays, too.
Yep, that's the word in town.
Need a ride? I can get you there.
Okay then, girl. Let's go, girl.
Guys are still unkind.
What you looking for? A paper?
So it goes.
Thanks. Have a great day.
Been a while since you were last here. Take a look. Any questions, feel free not to ask. All right, but if it has feathers or fur, keep it in the bag. How's your friend getting on? All right, bye then.
Oh, wasn't sure if I'd see you again. What can I offer you?
Now, let me have a look.
I maybe shouldn't say this, but I sold a derringer to a seamstress. A white one, of course. Now, I do have some foreign-made iron when it's quality, but here in Rhodes, America is preferred.
I'm looking forward to testing this out. Easy, easy.
Hey, friend.
Hello.
How was it in town?
Pretty hot. There's quite a price on you boys.
It is so unfair. I didn't do nothing.
Well, they said you was wanted for murder.
It wasn't murder. It was self-defense.
And you killed a farmer?
Well, firstly, I would have, but he died before I could. And secondly, well, he had it coming. I don't like to say.
Well,
no business of mine. Here's the posters.
Thanks, partner. That's that, then.
That's that.
Free at last.
Free from you, at least.
Well, not quite.
No?
We should wait a while first, see if anyone's on our trail.
You're right. Too risky to split up now.
Two sets of eyes is better than one.
This ain't permanent, though. It's a temporary measure.
Well, right, till things blow over.
Then I'm done with you, Black.
I'm counting the hours, White.
This is a second chance for us. We're grateful.
Slow up now.
Yep.
We don't need any more trouble. Good morning to you.
This man deserves no earthly respect from us. As a sign of respect to our Creator, we pay respect to the dead. Oh, Father, what do we say about a man who lost his way so awfully? He carried that awful war with him, rustling horses with a misguided gang of killers. A brave man, undone by pride, doomed to a life of sin and vice.
Tell it straight, Father.
Sir, we're in a moment of grief.
Hello.
Morning, partner.
Some real beautiful country around this area.
Let us pray for this man, oh Father. Provide him mercy. Amen.
Morning to you. Those were kind words, Father.
Maybe.
You sure run into some nice folks
words
out this way. All the best to you.
God be with you.
Enough! Let's see what the law says.
Yep.
You take care.
Morning.
Sir, good morning.
You remind me of a feller I used to know.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry. Can't put my finger on it.
You take care now.
Come here. Hey, boy. Hey there, girl.
Hello.
Whoa!
Enemies of Lemoyne is enemies of...
God bless you, mister.
Hey!
Ain't going till you get this right.
I can't, Daddy, please. Let him in. He's been trying for hours.
He ain't no kind of man till he... on a horse.
Don't shoot. I'm unarmed. We knew you was coming. I got something to ask. I'm a changed man, okay? Let me say my farewells. I'll come away peaceable.
Make it quick.
You're a forgiven man. Boy. Boy, come here. Listen. Exactly as I say. You hear?
Don't.
I ain't gonna fight you in front of my family. Okay? You gonna take me, or what?
This is bullcrap!
Don't look away, boy. You remember this moment. You're the man now. Be a man, boy.
We're going for a walk.
I love you, Daddy!
Enough with that. Just remember what I said, boy.
This might happen. Be thankful for the time you had.
damn you!
Be a man about this.
I'll do these tighter this time.
How's that?
Now what was the point in all that?
Could have got your neck broke prematurely. Belong to wearing roads. Johnson. Johnson!
What?
Just, you're real quiet back there. Most captured men, they beg or they cry or they rail against fate. You're almost shot of me.
I'm ready. I hope they make it quick. Love made my peace.
Okay. Fellers.
You need to move on now, friend.
I can see you're a fellow who ain't to be messed with. Found this feller on a small holding. Name's Mark Johnson.
You can only run so long, son. There's your cell. You're lucky it's not a grave.
I was out in the bayou. Wasn't hurting no one.
Maybe you weren't, but those partners of yours were a rough bunch.
Go to hell.
Well, now.
Yep, that's the word in town.
That's the price for Johnson.
I didn't take it, someone else would have.
You tell yourself that, bounty hunter. You ain't whiter than white. I hope your past catches up with you. We all deserve second chances, every one of us.
You hear the law was taking money from some road agents? They got caught.
Easy there. Okay, my girl. Huh? Easy.
Close in.
Yep. Easy. Yep. Now, where's this shine? Who we got here? Easy, whoa. Thank you.
enough.
Moonshot!
Man, wonderful!
You got my money?
It's for a very good cause. My name is Professor Andrew Bell III. Perhaps you've heard of me.
Can't say that I have.
Oh, I'm an inventor. Maybe you've read about me.
I don't read much.
Well, that's too bad. Oh, yes.
You got my money?
It is the most wonderful invention, friend. Oh, you, sir, have done a great deed.
All I've done is get some creep a lot of drink.
Creepers? Excellent. Nonsense. Now, you've helped me develop the most humane machine imaginable. A way to induce calmness to our most troubled souls. A way to end the barbarity of a public hanging. Oh, so, so humane.
What are you talking about?
The electric chair.
What?
See, it's a chair full of electricity. It's quite fascinating. It calmly and peacefully dispatches sinners to face judgment. Yes, judgment. Yeah.
Where is it?
Well, it's in my laboratory. The next thing I need is a demonstration. A public one. Do you know the police chief?
As well as anyone.
Oh, wonderful! Perhaps you can encourage him to let me demonstrate the chair. It will help bring this town into the next century. Yes, could you do that?
Thank you.
Ah.
I know you're in there! Come on out! You coward! We gonna talk about what you done to my wife! You're a dead man!
Somebody!
Hey! Who the devil are you?
Far as you're concerned, I am the devil. Now get out of here!
But this cad!
I said get out of here!
Yeah. Damn French.
I don't quite know why I did that.
Because barbarity is boring, no?
It kept me amused some years.
You must go, my friend, before the gendarmerie arrive.
Hey, you gonna do right by this feller's wife?
You have done right by her. The little bird is free. I am an artist, cowboy. I must do what I feel. Look, I have an exhibit at the gallery. You come, see what I mean.
Giddy up. Out of the damn way.
Welcome to our humble police house.
Chief, I'm representing the inventor of a humane execution machine. An electric chair. And he wants to demonstrate his invention here.
Ah, I'm familiar with the man and his work. Tell you what, I'll give you a permit. But it's gonna cost you $100 in fees.
Okay. Well, the price is fair. Here you go.
And here, sir, is your permit. Pending the usual formalities, of course, such as finding a suitable candidate for humane dispatchment.
I'll tell that to the professor.
Good luck.
Bonjour, monsieur. How are things with you?
I am an American. Come on, people. Let me vote. It's a national disgrace.
Hey, watch yourself.
Oh, excuse you. Let me vote. Let me vote. Let me vote. I can say this all day. Let me vote. Let me vote. Let me vote. I will say this for as long as it takes. Come on, people. Let me vote.
Hello, ma'am.
You, my friend, what do you think about women's suffrage?
Women voting? Sure, why not?
Oh, thank you, sir. You are a true progressive.
Anyone dumb enough to want to vote, I say go for it.
Oh, a cynic. How dull for you. I do hope you grow out of it, young man. It's so unappealing.
Unappealing is what I do best.
How are you today?
You're walking away from history, you fools! Women and men both deserve to decide the future. This is meant to be the land of liberty?
Bonsoir, monsieur.
But somehow, I am not free to vote? Who says that? Look me in the eye and tell me I am not the equal of any man you ever met.
Une bonne soirée à vous, monsieur.
Alms for the blind. Woman there, do you have anything to spare for a blind man? Oh, thank you, sir. Truly, thank you. It means a lot to me. Oh, good day to you. Do you have anything you can spare for a blind man?
Hello, Professor... Professor...
Andrew Bell the Third.
That's it. So, the chief says you can test out your machine, pending the usual formalities.
And what are they?
Finding a suitable, subject.
Ah, funny you should mention. This fella here, he seems sturdy enough, and he's guilty of sin.
Wilson J. McDaniels, wanted for murder, bigamy, and... immoral animal husbandry. What's that?
The mind shudders. Ugh. Here, find him for me and help me put him out of his misery.
Come on, girl.
Coming together wonderfully. The final piece of the puzzle.
Yep.
ain't moving.
Stay away from my camp. Time for you to get the hell out of here.
Just minding my own business.
Get the hell out of here right now! Help, please! Holy shit! Hey! Untie me, damn it!
Yeah, you don't mind, do you?
God damn.
Okay, then, girl.
Well, been a pleasure. Yep. Okay, they're gone.
Oh, God! Oh, God! Oh, no!
Let's go, girl. Yep.
Yeah, yeah. Damn you! Now, I'm just gonna check your pockets. You're coming with me.
Let's go.
There's...
You done good, girl.
Take me to damn court, then. This ain't America. We ain't free no more. Can't.
Sounds like sour grapes. You know, you ain't going to court. You ain't going to jail either. I'm taking you to a professor I know.
What in hell are you talking about?
You're a lucky man, mister. You get to be part of, great experiment.
Shut up!
You ain't gonna die needlessly, is what I mean. Nope. Your death's gonna be an important step in the advancement of human knowledge.
What in hell you saying, mister?
This professor, Andrew Bell III, I believe he said. He's a little odd, maybe harebrained, but I got no reason to doubt the quality of his work.
What's this damn professor got to do with anything?
Well, he wants to try this new electricity chair on you. To kill you. Humanely.
No!
Yeah. Well, he's gonna strap you into this contraption and run a large electric current through your system. Got something to do with moonshine. Don't quite know what. I guess that's why he's the professor and I'm the bounty catcher. Well, as I said, I can pass on his assurances that this is a most humane way to go. It'll be just like, well, like switching off a light.
They wouldn't let you do this to me. They wouldn't.
Oh, they would. And we got a permit and everything. You was in animal husbandry, am I right? Well, you ever seen lightning strike livestock, Mr. McDaniels? Now, I ain't ever seen the actual impact, but I came across a pasture sometime after. Storm had just cleared, and there was smoke in the air, smell of burning hair.
No.
Must have been a dozen head of cattle, lying there, piled up, mangled. Strange scars across their backs, legs, and necks. It's half like they was burned, half like the skin was ripped off.
No.
Eyes bleeding. Some of them popped out.
No!
If I hadn't seen the storm, I would have thought some devil caused that mischief. But no, sir. It was lightning. Electricity does something, all right. I seen trees explode in front of me. I seen desert sand baked into glass. That's what I seen lightning do. But, you know, hey. This electricity professor's got a plan for you. Ah, that must be of it.
That's the fellow that took our moonshine.
Shit!
You better not disappoint me, fellas.
Daniels, you all right? Yeah, me too. Well, you'll be happy to know we ain't got far to go. Hold on tight now.
believe it.
Shit! Look at the floor for a bit. You're all right now, girl. Okay, girl. Good girl.
Cleaning up the land, one troublemaker at a time, huh?
Well, here we are. The professor will be real pleased to meet you. Here, I got him.
You're
wonderful.
Come on.
Wonderful.
Don't be shy now. Let's go.
Oh, lay him over here.
Now, where's my money?
Money?
Yeah, for all the running around I've been doing.
Oh, well. Once they buy my humane electric ending facilitator, there'll be money enough for you, sir.
Well, let's hope.
All right, let's get our poor unfortunate ready for the demonstration. Oh, do come and watch. It'll be amazing. Come along.
Get away from me!
Oh, no, no.
Good morning, sir.
Okay, bud?
Fantastic. You Americans are nothing but shysters and traitors and slippery tongue bull suckers.
I'm inclined to agree.
Here, help me, please. Back to work with a bloody smile. No problem, Marco. You are the great genius, so we shall the hot poker up the ass. Say thank you, Marco. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
What are you, some kind of European toy maker?
No, I am a fucking genius with poker up the ass, like I say. Toy maker. Hello? Do I look like I should entertain children?
No.
No, he says. No. I am the savior of the mankind, Bobby. Yes, you meet him. Professor Marco Dragic. The one the silver tongue American betrayed and not paid the money to. Yes, he told to shit, man.
So, what's this toy about?
It is not a toy, Big Nuts. It is demonstration of my genius, of my ideas about the source of life.
Oh, it's a toy boat.
Yes, it is a toy boat that I can power remotely using electricity in ways you cannot see.
Good for you. Ways I cannot see.
And still the investors will not come. Just a couple of old ladies and a moron.
Ladies, please.
Ladies! Gentlemen! Enchanté. Hello. Hello, sir. Okay. How is the piles? Yeah? Good, good, good. Okay. My friends, you are about to witness history. A demonstration of my infinite insight. All of us, we feel old. You are old. Oh. But maybe I can make you immortal. Using waves you cannot see. I will power this boat.
You're a goddamn fraud. And this buffoon, dressed up like a buffoon, is a stoolie. I watch them conspire, you morons.
I never met this buffoon before 2 minutes ago. Isn't that right?
Which part of it?
So, Professor, show us your magical toy boat. Only this time let the buffoon control it. Check if there's any funny business.
No, this ain't nothing to do with me.
Come, please, please. It is easy. Any moron could do it, and I am about to prove that. Here, take this, and this, and... Don't touch that. Use these ones to steer and this one to shoot torpedoes, okay? Yes, now blow up the little battleships and avoid the sea mines. They have magnets attached. Make nasty explosion if they touch the bot. Okay! If this silly dimwit can use torpedoes on boat to destroy the battleships, imagine what technology can do in the hands of certified genius! And I have certificate.
Hey, it's doing what I'm telling it.
Of course it is doing. Now, tell it to do closer to battleship and shoot with torpedo.
I got one, see?
Yes, very well done. You see what he does? No wire like telegraph. No pulley system underwater. Only waves in the air.
This is remarkable. Think of those poor boys on the H.L. Hunley. 8 of them perished to a mere 5 on the Housatonic. What a way to go. Trapped in a box at the bottom of the bay. I suppose you intend to make an unmanned killing machine?
You misunderstand. This is the secret to life. Not that. The trans...
There. All gone for you.
Yes, you see what he does? Now, bring the boat back to the dock.
That sure was something. But I'm not sure what, if anything, was proven here.
The demonstration's not over yet. Any fool can explore the sitting dock.
Let me just reload her.
This is really remarkable.
This is just a demonstration of my prowess, sir. The real miracles require investment. Now the dimwit will use invisible waves to destroy the little sailing boats before they get to other side of pond, still avoiding magnetic mines.
Oh, he'll attempt to, at least.
Shush! You're not here for this smart talk. The steam train, the telegraph machine, the motor car. They will all seem pedestrian in comparison to this technology. We are not reliant on wires or coal or gasoline. No, just rays in the air. Like the voice of God.
And funding from us?
And funding from you, of course. But what thing to fund? What an opportunity! No one is stupid enough to pass this up. Not even Dimwit here.
Hey,
you really all work on your salesmanship.
Americans, all you think about is sales. You avoid the mines, yes? That's what controls are for.
Look who rules the seas.
Very good, very good. Now bring in the boat back here. Foolproof. Undeniably foolproof. But you are not fools. As I say, any fool, huh? Thank you, thank you.
What is that?
It is the stuff of life, sir.
It's incredible.
No. Incredible things are in my lab, back at Dover Hill. That will astound all of you. Mr. Marcel, can I count on your support?
Well, this is expensive.
It is immortality, sir. It is very cheap. Perhaps over lunch.
Maybe.
I'm gonna go.
Oh, yeah, of course. And thank you. If you're ever up near Dover Hill, pay me a visit. There, I will really amaze you. I hope you will forgive my European course.
Stay.